Welcome to today's podcast. I probably say this every time we open up, but I'm excited about what I'm about to deliver because that's just how I am about the Word. Someone sent me a little message and said something that I'd said to them so many years ago, probably 30 years ago, and it's get in the Word, get in the Word, get in the Word. And that's always been something so inside of me. This is a love letter from the Father to us. Jesus is the Word. And in this, Bible tells us everything we need to know. It gives us instructions. First of all, to me, it gives us revelation of the Father. Jesus said he came. I like that, to make the Father known. He said, I only do what the Father tells me to do. I only say what the Father tells me to say. And I don't know, but it just seems here lately, that's something that goes over in my spirit all the time, Datha. Only do what the Father tells you to do. Only say what the Father tells you to say. Now, folks, I don't expect to do that 100%. I'm human. But that's going to be a goal that I check even more so. I've been doing a series on the gifts of the Spirit. Actually, I've been doing a series on how to flow in the Spirit. To woo the Holy Spirit, the manifestation of the Holy Ghost. It should be in the life of every believer. It is the tools. It's what God gave us. Excuse me. So we can live a victorious life. God is a supernatural God. And when Christ came in us, come on now, we became natural people, but equipped supernatural. What really concerns me, it just seems so much today, is that people don't flow in the supernatural. And it's like they're silencing God. They're hindering God from being able to do what he wants to do through believers. Every believer should have the baptism of the Holy Ghost with the evidence of speaking in tongues. Every believer should be open to the spirit realm, to the manifestation, to the gifts of the Spirit flowing, because don't hinder God. I like the scripture, and we'll start off from there when it says this, Acts 1:8, but you shall receive power in the Amplified. I like how it amplifies. It says the ability, the efficiency, the might, when the Holy Spirit has come upon you. And you shall be my witnesses in Jerusalem, all Judea and Samaria, and to the ends, the very bounds of the earth. And when he had said this, even as they were looking at him, he was caught up, talking about Jesus, caught up, and a cloud received and carried him away out of their sight. I like that because when we receive the Holy Spirit, it's more than just an ability to pray in tongues. It is the power of the Holy Spirit. It's the ability of the Holy Spirit. It's the efficiency of the Holy Spirit. It's the might and the glory of God. So I want you to realize there's that realm of the Spirit that I want you to understand more than what you've ever understood it before. I was thinking about my life and wondering where I would have been today if I had not been raised in a church where I saw the gifts of the Spirit in operation. I saw prophecy speak forth, tongues and interpretation. In 1 Corinthians chapter 12, it's called spiritual, and they've added the word gifts, but concerning spiritual, brethren, I would not have you ignorant. And yet it seems today, by and large, the church, the body of Christ, they're ignorant. Even if they know they exist, they don't understand that in this book gives you guidelines on how to flow in that realm of the Spirit. Let me read Acts chapter 19, verse 1. And it came to pass that while Apollos was at Corinth, Paul, having passed through the upper coast, came to Ephesus, and finding certain disciples, that means they were already born again, he said to them, have you received the Holy Spirit since you believed? And they said, we have not so much as heard whether there be any Holy Ghost. And he said unto them, into what then were you baptized? And they said, into John's baptism. Then said Paul, John truly baptized with the baptism of repentance, saying unto the people that they should believe on him, whom should come after him, that is Christ Jesus. When they heard this, they were baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. So that was accepting Jesus and being baptized. And when Paul laid hands upon them, the Holy Ghost came on them, and they spake with tongues and prophesied. And all the men were about 12. So there were like a lot of believers today that were born again, but they had not received, we use the phrase, the baptism of the Holy Spirit, the infilling of the Holy Spirit. Salvation is what you need to go to heaven. But I've learned to live here in this world. You need the baptism of the Holy Ghost. Why? It's the doorway to the gifts of the Spirit operating. It has changed my life tremendously. And I see how he has changed the lives of so many people when someone who knows how to flow and releases, I'll say it this way, an impartation into them. Let me read this scripture to you in 1 Corinthians 12. It says this, how is it then, brethren, when you come together, every one of you have the psalm, have the doctrine, have the tongue, have the revelation, have an interpretation. Let all things be done unto edifying. Now he's dealing with the Corinthian church because they had the gifts of the Spirit in operation, but they didn't know the guidelines. I remember with the great charismatic movement, it was wonderful, it was marvelous, but people of every different denomination received the baptism of the Holy Ghost, but they didn't always have leaders there that would teach them how the gifts flowed. And so you would have confusion sometimes. And in that confusion, a lot of people, I'll say, and chaos, a lot of things came from the flesh of a man and not from the Spirit of God, but there was no one there to judge. So I've always said, if you're going to flow in the gifts of the Spirit, be hooked up to someone who can tell you, no, you're missing it there, or encourage you in another avenue. But listen what it says here. He said, have you received since you believed? Go with me to 1 Corinthians chapter 12. Now concerning spiritual, and they've added the word gifts. If it's italicized, it's an added word. Now concerning spiritual, brethren, I would not have you ignorant. I remember the story told me about a lady in the grocery store, and she just began speaking in tongues. Everybody around her thought she was mad. And somebody said, well, that was the Holy Ghost. I said, no, it wasn't. I said, the Spirit is subject to the prophet. The Holy Ghost don't come on you and make you do that. I said, if you're baptized in the Holy Ghost, you have the ability to pray in tongues, but you choose to pray. It doesn't make you pray. And so some of these things, I'll call it chaos, some of these things that are not scriptural, started happening in all different places, and many churches begin to close as far as being open to the gifts of the Spirit in operation. Full Gospel Businessmen's Fellowship was really tremendously used by God. And so many men, and they opened it up to women, also received the baptism of the Holy Ghost. But they gave them advice I don't think was correct, but I'm not God. They told him to stay in their church. So they stayed in their churches, and so they didn't flow except when they come together, but it was not anyone there that was skilled in, understood how the gifts flowed. And so they got a little, I'll say it this way, a little chaos, a little nutty. I've watched over the years, this has been over 40-year period. When that began to happen, I would say to them, but you have no one to help you in instructions. If you do not stay with someone that knows how to help you and train you, pretty soon you won't be praying in tongues. Pretty soon, the gift of speaking in tongues, come on now, it will not be in your life, and it will dwane away. And that's exactly what happened. So today, even I say it this way, even in Pentecostal churches, you don't see gifts of the Spirit in operation like they should be. Someone asked me, why do I think that? I said, well, it's not being taught. Number one, when revelation of the word comes, when the Spirit of God breathes on the revelation of the word, there will be some flowing of the gifts. Not every time, but many times. So I said, we have a lot of people who are born again, filled with the Holy Ghost, but they were never trained how to flow in it. And that's so sad, because all this great power and might and revelation that is available to the church, you don't see it in the church like you should see it. I always said a church should not be a bless me club, but a church should also be a training center. I remember one of our members gave out a prophecy, and right in the middle of it, she stopped, and she just sort of rambled a little bit. It was in line with the word, but it wasn't prophecy. And she stopped right in the middle of it, and she said, oh, I'm so sorry. That's just me. And I said, you began with hearing from the Spirit of God. You got nervous, and that came out of your own spirit. I said, stop, pray in tongues, begin again, and you'll hit it. That's exactly what she did. I love that. A church should help people, train people, how to be open, how to flow. That's our job. The Spirit of God said in 1 Corinthians chapter 12, brethren, I would not have you ignorant. That means you can still be a believer, but be ignorant on how the gifts of the Spirit flow. So I'm telling you today, let's begin, because let's be one that understands how it flows. It says this, I like this, I wrote this down. Don't get in one ditch or the other. 1 Corinthians chapter 14, 23. If therefore the whole church become together into one place and all speak in tongues, and there come in those that were unlearned or unbelievers, will they not say that you're mad? But if all prophesy and there come in one that believeth not, or one unlearned, he is convinced of all, he is judged of all. And thus are the secrets of his heart made manifest. And so falling down on his face, he will worship God and report that God is in you of a truth. He said, if you come to a church service and everybody there is praying in tongues, they are going to think you're mad, because it doesn't benefit them. But if someone stood up and gave a message, a prophecy that has revelation in it, that means reveal something, it'll prick the heart even of those that don't know God. And he'll say, there's something different about this. They'll realize that God has spoken. This is needed in every local church, the supernatural power of God. I remember one time at church, on Saturday, the Lord said, you're going to have somebody come to your church tomorrow. He told me exactly who they would be. Now, I'm using me as an example, but this could be so many more members of our church and any church where they teach on the gifts. He said, and they have been telling everybody all week that they're a tough nut to crack. So when I came to Sunday, I looked to the ladies that God had shown me this man was with, and they were not together. But after they got through with the singing and came down to sit in the pew, guess what? They sat right there by that man. And I said, hey, mister, I said, I've been praying for you. I said, the Lord told me that you've been going around telling to everybody you're a tough nut to crack. I said, sir, come up here. I'm going to pray for you. And the Holy Spirit's going to crack you wide open. And now you're going to know of a surety that God is real. Why? The revelation came with prophecy, and God said something to that man that he knew there's no way I could have heard it from anybody but the Spirit of God. Now, I want you to know these gifts are available to believers, but you have to, I'll say it this way, you cannot be ignorant. This book, everything is guided by this book. The gifts of the Spirit flowing will not contradict this Bible. It will never contradict the word. So I want a hunger to be put inside of you. Let me tell you about another revelation gifts. It doesn't matter who the person was. It was just someone in the church. And God revealed to them, and they gave, this was given out. There's someone here that when you get off work, it's way in the wee hours of the morning, and you stop at a store like a convenience store, and you get something to drink, something that is cold. Not beer, not wine, something that is cold. And God said that there are people there that have a plot. They're going to do you harm. God said, don't go back to that location in order to be saved. Now, what if that person was not there that day and the gifts of the Spirit did not operate that day? Do you realize there could have been harm to that man? God was wanting to speak to that young person and change their very life. I want you to know God's interested in us. He cares about us. He wants intimacy with us. He wants to be able to talk to us, give us, I said this way, give us wisdom, give us guidance, give us discernment. There's nothing like discernment. There was a man that came to our church and we realized there was some wrong spirits on him. And so he was called to the office. There was a note. God had the person write a note. And so it was folded over and the person said to him, you have a spirit on you. And I have written on this piece of paper and put it in an envelope what spirit you have. If you'll confess it, we'll pray for you and you'll be delivered. I'll give you the envelope. You can open it up and know that we knew all along. But if you don't confess it, we will not give you the envelope. They said, there's nothing wrong with me. So we gave him the instructions. Don't be around our children. Don't go to any youth meeting. When you show up, someone will be assigned. Well, guess what? It wasn't long before they were arrested and charged with child molestation. Are you listening to me? Are you understanding? God wants to talk to us. He wants to bless us. He wants to protect us. He wants to provide for us. And he's given us the gifts of the Spirit that he can speak to us on a day-to-day basis. He can give you warning. He can tell you blessings. He wants to help us in our journey. He said, I'll not leave you like an orphan, but I'll give you the Holy Spirit who will come in and live and be with you forever. Well, I pray this has blessed you. We're just on the starting place. God bless you.